a good crowd. Welcome back to the Intel Extreme Masters Cologne for one of the final matches. We've got just two more matches left in Group D now to decide the final player into the quarterfinals, which start tomorrow. So don't want to miss that. Four quarterfinals, two semis, and the grand final to crown our first 2014 Intel Extreme Masters Cologne champion. And we'll find out the two slots that go off to Katowice. Joined by Mr. Kolaris. It's a big game right now, a huge game for Germany right now. It's like a home football match against England. What? Kind of.
The Germans don't care about playing us.
No, they don't matter the other way because they kick our butts every time. They do worry about that. Okay, so innovation safely through. Predictable?
Well, I imagined MC was going to put up a bit more of a fight, but in the end, I mean, innovation showed stellar colours during those games. It was really nice to watch those engagements going down. Very, very impressive play by innovation all around. And it's nice to see him move on to the round of eight. It's where he deserves to be.
Okay, we're going to move on to our final, well, second to last game in this group. Let's show the brackets, actually. So if you are just joining us and you're unaware of what's going on in Group D, this is how it looks so far. MC beating Classic 2-1 in his first game and then losing 2-0 to Innovation in the second one. Innovation going through, but Hero Marine not doing too well in his first match. He's going to get a chance at redemption now, though. He goes head-to-head with Classic. SKT1's Classic.
Yep.
And in essence, he's going against another top Korean. It's more experience, but the question the crowd want to know here is, can he win? Be careful what you say if you don't want to get lynched.
All right, guys. Classic's kind of... Although, I must say, right? No, in my defense, I must say, okay, the Classic's PVT is a little bit unknown, so... We don't know what's going to happen. He doesn't really play them in their PVTs. He plays PVZ and PVP.
Hold on. I've heard some fence sitting in my time, right?
Yeah.
But I think you might have splinters in your behind right now. Can you just answer the question? Tell me, is it Hero Marine or is it Classic?
It might be Classic.
Out!
Okay, so Kolaris has, unfortunately, retired from commentary and... left the building very quickly via an escape route at the rear of the building and may not be in any kind of trouble whatsoever with the German crowd here. And with that, it's time now to go over to our commentary team who are going to guide you through our final second to last game here at the Intel Extreme Masters with Hero Marine versus Classic. Take it away, guys.
Thank you very much, Red Eye, and a Protoss and a Zerg to commentate a Protoss versus a Terran.
Yeah, but we did this yesterday.
How do you feel about this one? Yes, we've done this before. You actually played Terran yourself, so definitely going to be interesting. What do you think of Innovation versus MC just now?
It was a really good matchup. I feel like Innovation deserved to win. He played a little bit better than MC.
Of course he deserved to win, he won.
Yeah, of course.
The pair who deserves to win the most always wins.
Sometimes, no.
Except when he faces Burlord and Infestors, as I did many times against you.
Or Protoss. Right now.
This is not the start I was hoping for.
No,
right?
No. Of course, Innovation, you know, he played really well and you know, he just played better than MSC and he did really well to win that series.
All right, we'll see here how Hero Marine matches up versus Classic in a moment. Mavito is about to take place. There was a very interesting tweet that was made by Hero Marine. Right after losing his first match to Innovation, he tweeted, "Went as expected. My Terran versus Korean Terran, not so good, but I think my Terran versus Protoss is a lot better. But what about my Terran versus Korean Protoss?" Yeah. So I guess we'll find out here in a second. And I wouldn't be surprised if we see the standard Mavitos here. Alter Zim Stronghold by Hero Marine. I still think this is broken. It's showing the wrong side, because then again...
Well, this is a really large map, so it probably Hero Marine does not want to play that map. But it is kind of true. You know, Hero Marine plays against a lot of good Protoss on the European ladder, but now he's thrown into the deep with a Classic, who's a Pro League SKT1 starting lineup player, which is like a totally different level than anything Hero Marine is really used to. So even though he might be really confident in his TVP, you always kind of wonder, like, yeah, I may have won, like, 10 out of the last 15 ladder games on Europe server.
I may have beaten Hazuops and Grubby recently, but this is Classic. This is going to be another story here.
Yeah.
And, not to take anything away from these guys, of course.
Classic living in a team house, you know, every day he's probably talking about PvT, like, how can I take the most advantage of whatever build Terran is doing? And he's talking about that with all of his teammates.
And Haziel just laughs. And never answers. It seemed like three very standard maps here. I think I saw Yeonsu, Polar Knight, and Frost would make the most sense. And I don't know how he plays like this. I could not, man.
Yeah, he's a small guy, so I guess he just has lots of space to put his legs everywhere he wants.
What about you? How do you play?
Well, I sometimes actually sit like this, but after like 10 minutes, my leg falls asleep, and then I can't do it anymore, but so I just sit pretty standard.
Why don't you wake it up then?
Well, I'm like, I yell at it. I'm like, hey, wake up, hey, wake up. It just doesn't respond.
All right, so what do you expect out of this matchup here? Classic versus Hero Marine. Do you think Hero Marine tries to play a standard and straight up game?
Yeah, I think Hero Marine always goes for the standard game. I don't really see him all in that much. But I don't know. I'm scared for him if he plays a standard game against Classic here. I feel like Classic is going to bring the sharpest builds he can possibly bring to this matchup. He's going to have every timing down to a T. He's not going to make a lot of mistakes. And if Hero Marine wants to even have a chance to win, he's going to have to do the exact same thing.
Yeah. Surely Classic expects a rematch against MC here shortly. Mm. And he came into this with a lot of hype. Rain delivered earlier. Now it was Classic's time. Classic had some great results in the qualifier for this tournament. He beats some of the world's best pros, basically all of them, except maybe MC. And now he lost to MC.
Yeah, he lost to MC, but I feel like the games, if you watch them, they pretty much just did the exact same thing.
I commentated them.
Yeah. And Classic played the same way MC did. He just like had this slight disadvantage in the build order. I didn't feel like his play was like disappointing or he made any big mistakes. He just got the short straw of the build orders. And I don't think we've seen the last of Classic. He still has got the opportunity to make a big impact on this tournament. And he's looking to start by taking out the young German.
And make it a Classic run? I'm sorry, I had to.
All right,
let's get the game underway. First map is going to be played on Frost here. And actually, Hero Marine, how likely do you think it is that he goes for something like a Command Center first? He's been known to, four players map, use it quite often.
Yeah, this is the map to go Command Center first. We also saw Jakji do it on Frost every single time against Portos. And it seems to be a pretty standard opening on a four-player map, so... That's what I'm expecting from
Again, it's kind of fell out of fashion sometimes, just because now it's been figured out a lot more how to counter. Either you play greedy or you go for some kind of pressure. And Protoss have been scouting a lot more. Anyway, those two players here, one of them will be eliminated at the end of this match. One of them will go on to face MC for the last qualifying spot for the round of 8. Introductions are all yours, my friend.
All right. In the top right of Frost, it is the red Protoss, none other than SKT1 Classic. And in the top left of Frost, it is the young German hero, Mr. Hero Marine.
Which and is definitely the fan favorite here in Germany.
Did you notice Classic's chin? Very powerful chin. And I remember in the Eastro house, I was actually in the Eastro house when Classic was in Eastro, and the players somehow got this superstitious belief that if they were to touch Classic's chin before the match, it would bring good luck.
So everybody always went.
Every time there was a Pro League match, all the players would go over and just gently touch his chin.
How did he take it?
For good luck. Yeah, he was okay with it. I mean,
really?
He took it to the chin quite well.
Oh, God.
It's a true story.
This is getting out of hand. I have a quite powerful nose myself, but nobody ever touches it for good luck.
Well,
man.
If you want, I can touch it before next time I play a tournament.
It's fine. Well, then again, you couldn't do worse than you... Oh, no, just kidding. You're a full-time caster now, man. Get used to it.
Yeah, I am enjoying the Switch.
You're doing a very good job.
I'm still in the tournament. It's already the third day. This hasn't happened in a while.
All right, Hero Marine here. He did go for a fairly quick gas, I think a gas 12, so we're going to be seeing a Reaper opener out of him, whereas Classic, no second gas yet, and he didn't go for a scout. He's one of those guys that has been reluctant to go for some kind of very, very early scout, even versus MC, whereas a lot of Protosses will go for, say, a Gateway 13 followed up by a scout here. Even versus Terran, he does not seem to want to scout early on. And he did that nice wall with his base, which... And, becoming a big fan of.
So far, Hero Marine is going for the wrong scout first, so a little bit unlucky for him. What do you think about these positions? Does this affect the TVP matchup a lot?
Yeah, you can I've covered this a little bit before. Basically, you can drop easier, but if you're the Protoss, then you can anticipate it very well and know which direction it's going to come from. You're never going to see a Terran basically go all the way around the map and then drop into the natural of the Protoss. Will take quite long. So Hero Marine, he goes for a reactor behind this. He stops mining gas at 100. He gets the command center down. Actually, with that late scout, Classic might... he's going to get lucky. He's going to go around that Reaper as Hero Marine is going to... try and do some damage, but the Mothership Core should prevent this happening. Yeah. Always, man. What else did you expect out of Classic? You said it yourself.
Yeah. He brings the Razor Sharp Builders, no doubt.
And, not Factory. Sorry.
Second Barracks
out of Hero. This could be a similar opener to what we've seen Paul do earlier. If the third Barracks goes down, he was going to want to make sure, basically, that he's safe against either Blink or Stargates. Both of them, and he's going to favorize basically huge bio forces early on rather than tech or upgrades.
And he's going to have to fight against the Photon Overcharge here, so...
We have a cheeky little probe on the bottom left-hand side of the map.
Gonna go Target going down for Classic.
Yeah.
What does this mean?
Well, Oracle.
Oracle?
I wonder if this is because of the positions here. Maybe he thinks he can sneak, basically go in the corner of the map and go up against the very limit of it, make sure he does not get caught on the way and surprise his opponent.
But he's seen two barracks. Don't you think that Phoenix is also a possibility?
No, it's horrible. It's actually horrible to go for a Phoenix in this case, I think. Because you just cannot do much against it. Your opponent's getting a lot of Marines. You're not going to be able to get any kills. They will get turrets and then they are useless. So if you get an Oracle out, you can keep it alive. You can do some damage here and there. You can make sure it does not die. And it's going to be the priority. If you keep it alive and you get some kills here and there, when your opponent moves out, you use the Revelation spell. And you know exactly where his army is at all times. It's going to make it so much easier to defend against any kind of assault. And the target was actually spotted, but I'm not sure if your Marine had time to click on it.
I think he saw it. He's definitely got his Marines positioned in his main base, waiting for any Oracle. And he's actually going for a very fast factory, so... I feel like this is a pretty nice opening for Hero Marine. It's going to have reasonably fast medevacs.
It's a good opening for Hero Marine, you say?
I believe.
Watch that guy over here. Watch him.
Yeah, well, that guy is pretty OP.
All right. But we'll find out how OP in a second. As Hero Marine is actually in position with his Marines.
He's going to go to the natural, and there's already some Marines there. So, Classic, how many kills do you think he's going to get with this?
Zero for now. Surely, and with the Twilight going down behind this very quickly, and double gateways being added on, I'm pretty sure that Classic is going to go into armor, charge loss, and most likely Templars behind this. Ooh, look at that CV.
Wow, a lot of damage already on that Oracle. Hero Marine doing really well to position his Marines, and like you said, zero kills.
One. He got the SCV that was building the starport. And that Oracle didn't do well at all and took quite some damage, man. Should have touched his own chin before playing.
And Classic looks to be going into, like you said, a more of a defensive setup on two bases. Getting the charge lots, getting the fast armor upgrade. Already getting the Templar archive, so that's very fast.
Yeah.
This basically means that for a long time, Classic is not going to really do anything to Hero Marine, but once he gets Storm, he's going to be able to move out on the map.
Yeah, but to be honest, I don't think he's going to move out before a very long time, because when you do that, and your opponent drops you in your base, then you're committed to a huge attack. So what we should see him do right now is go up to something like 8 gateways.
He's adding a lot of gates.
Yeah. You need to go up to 8 gateways if you don't have a robo.
He's getting a Phoenix.
This is the number.
I predicted this.
Oh, he's getting single one to maybe help against spotting some drops or something like that, but you predicted Phoenixes maybe.
Yeah, I know, predicted a Phoenix.
Okay. All right. I'll give you a cookie later.
I'm ahead of the meta.
Plus one's on the way here for your main for the attack.
Marine actually moving out here, and his two medevacs are going to be done pretty soon. Do you think he's going to be able to get anything done with this this strike force?
I don't think so. But then again, there is no storm. Oh, Classic goes for an Archon. He's very, very scared of this. He wants to play it safe. He's not going to underestimate his opponent here. He has a very little army supply, actually. So he's catching up right now. 33 to 42. He's just warping in a lot of Zealots. And thank God he made all those gateways, man. Imagine if he had been on 3 gateways. He might just have taken quite some damage here. And he's not starting storm because of this. He starts level 2 ground armor instead.
And Hero Marine actually moving into Classic's army, but backing off. And Hero Marine is now adding a third CC. And I think he's definitely going to get something done here with his Medivac. But the Phoenix is already in position.
But so did they So did they. They saw him, and they're going to go and chase for a second, realizing that they can't pick up anything. Oh, he's actually going to move out and chase this. He has charge. Those phoenixes, you want them to be able to kill the medivacs.
Ah, one gets picked off so fast.
Nice micro. And actually, those marines are going to have to steam away for now. And he cannot even pick them up. Ooh. Could have seen those marines turn around here and do some damage. Hero Marine is going to regroup.
Another one gets picked
off. Whoa, classic.
What are you doing?
It's a pick up on one of the marines, a snipe on another, but Hero Marine is ahead on supply now. Where does he scan?
Well, but he can't really fight against these Zealots, and the Zealots just run in and classic backsolve once again, getting chased a little bit. There's four medevacs now, that's a lot of healing power.
Third command center is going down, it's almost finished. And behind this we have a Ghost Academy, but Hero Marine is getting chased down. He's had to steam so many times. This army is very low on hit points. He needs to let it heal for some time. And behind this we don't actually have any kind of transition yet from classic, but since he's getting the Robo, she's probably going to be adding Colossus. He chooses that instead of Blink. Almost always the right choice, I feel. And he's leaving a Phoenix on patrol over here. This is really, really smart. Really going to help in spotting these drops and defending against them. The thing is, if Hero Marines paid attention to innovation against MC, we might see... What? He's getting personal clocking very, very quickly.
Yeah, he's going to have like 14-minute cloaked ghosts.
This is going to be very scary. I think he realized that there is no observers against him. Imagine if he scans and goes for, like, as you said, a 14 minutes cloak ghost attack. This is going to be quite deadly.
Yeah, man, he's already building up a huge medevac force as well. And I think Classic, even though he defended really, really well, Hero Marine is looking pretty dangerous here with a huge army.
But Classic is still ahead on supply.
And there's Storm done. And he's going to attack now. He's got 5 Templars here.
He's cutting pro production quite heavily, by the way, right now. He's just resumed it, but he's a little bit behind on Walkers. Quite far ahead on supply, 77 to 66 right now. But the upgrade is going to be important as well. Level 2 ground armor for Classic. Only plus 1. About to be 1-1 Hero Marine. And man, how deadly do you think this is going to be, this ghost attack? And how many does he go?
It's really going to all come down to just how good are the EMP is going to be. Yeah. Is he going to get the snipes off? Because like it's a pretty even fight. There's a lot of Templars. There's going to be a lot of ghosts.
You think he goes with 5? Would you?
Yeah, if I was there,
the SCVs.
I would go with 5.
The SCVs are
he's
being
just
pulled.
Transferring, though.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, you're getting so excited. Oh, yeah. Look at that Storm drop. That's a lot of debt workers.
Yeah, that was pretty
that's
good.
11 debt workers. That's a nice... nice.
I really thought he was going to pull SCVs here for a second. I guess that's what I anticipated since we had Innovation be quite successful with this. But actually, if you look at the main of Hero Marine, 3 turrets are going up. So he wants to make sure he's basically War Prism and Harass Proof. Against, he just wants to make sure he doesn't have to send units back.
Hero Marine has to be really careful here.
Oh,
there's
yeah.
Templars well spread out.
Having the Watchtower is a big deal. And there is actually an Observer just right above the army, so that's cloaking. Oh, this might backfire. Those Classics notice the blur moving towards him. He's going to have to be careful.
Classics going
Hero Marine should scan. If he sees the Observer, this will change everything.
Oh, look at that. Drop from the War Prism. Nice Storm there. And all these Zealots, so many Zealots, just rushing into the Marines. Another great Storm right on top of the army. And Classic is kind of just destroying
I really thought that Hero Marine was going to be the one attacking, but a Classic to the action to him and huge storms eating everything right now. Are you kidding me?
Oh my god, GG. Not even a single EMP or a single snipe. Classic just storms in, storms everything, and then takes the game.
Was that game on fast forward or something? Because, like, I cannot believe this happened so fast. He just moved in there with the War Prism. He's like, get out of my game. I'm going to storm you. You're done.
Hero Marine had ghosts and... He's smiling, he seems to be quite happy about something.
Probably thinking Korean's not bad.
Yeah, well, I guess he answered his own question.
Classic's not impressed one bit.
No.
He didn't even break a sweat here. Man, that War Prism, that was
very nice.
Such
he dropped
a deadly
it right
attack.
In front of the army.
Yeah.
And just, he didn't
that
care,
was so
just
fast.
Everything.
That was so fast too, I did not expect. You never see fights like this. Lasting like literally 1 second, like the storm, I think it hit like 30 units or something. It was absolutely ridiculous
storms there.
And there was Ghost too, that cloak. Hero Marine didn't use it for some time. He didn't see the War Prism coming. That was the biggest mistake. And in the end, super quick and actually anticlimactic end to what was gearing up to be possibly
was,
a very
was
entertaining
setting up for
game.
A nice mid game where we see like these Ghost Templar back and forth battles, but Classic was having none of it. And Hero Marine, you know, I have to say, he's played 3 games so far. And in every single game, he's kind of been looked outclassed by his Korean opponent, which is no shame because these are the top-level Koreans. But I feel like everybody here, even though we knew Hero Marine was not the favorite, was expecting just a little bit more.
Yeah.
And we'll have to see if he can bring it in the next game, because, you know, he has played amazing games online, especially. But you have to wonder as well how much he's
feeling
the pressure here.
Yeah.
Playing offline against...
He doesn't look very tense, to be honest.
Yeah, he seems
very
relaxed.
The game's otherwise.
But maybe that's not good. Maybe he's not tense enough, you know? Maybe he's got to focus harder and be at least a little bit more nervous to bring out the best.
Do you think it's a bad thing if you're not nervous at all?
If you don't care at all, I don't think that's good.
Oh, he cares. I'm pretty sure he cares.
But look at him. He's not phased at all. I'm sure he cares, but if I was sitting there, I would be looking differently. I would be, like, sweating and, like, trying to tell myself, yeah, play better, do better. You don't want to go out like this. Like, you want to do better.
He's probably telling that. He's just being positive about the loss. He's probably thinking he just got outclassed in that last game.
Well, he's young. He's still got a positive outlook on life.
You don't?
He doesn't. I've had too many losses in my days. It's affected my mindset.
Speaking of mindset, how do you think he goes into this next game here after this severe loss? Does he try and play standard again? This really is his style. You don't see Hero Marine cheese much versus Protoss. To me, he's known as the guy who loves to macro, who loves to go for quick third commencers, actually. So we could be possibly seeing him go for a little bit of a gamble here with a quicker third base. The thing is, as I said before, ideally, if you open with a one Rax commencer, that's with no gas, of course. That's when you go for the third commencer most of the time. Going for third commencer right now, it's a lot trickier than it used to.
Yeah, well, his two base, even though his two medevacs were very fast, he really never looked in a real position to get anything done. I mean, charge was already done. There were Phoenix to kill the medevacs. Storm was very fast, so Classic kind of looked impeccable in his defense.
Yeah.
And Hero Marine has to wonder, like, what should I do now? Like, I tried some pressure. Now the map is Yeonsu, though, which is a bit of a closer map. Also, perhaps more cheese-friendly for TVP. What are you expecting on this map?
I don't know. Classic, he seems to like to play standard and basically crush his opponent with regular play. Does not try to do anything too fancy too often. And I expect something like that of him, some kind of expansion. Maybe a pressure opener, but not non-super committal. All right. Introduction all yours once again.
Here in the top right of Yeonsu, representing SKT1, the red Protoss, Classic.
Do you know what SKT means?
SK Telecom.
Yeah, what does SK mean?
Philippines?
South Korea.
Really?
South Korea Telecom.
Really? That's what it
means?
Yeah. I never knew that. All right. Here in the bottom left, the very own German player, the Blue Terran. It is Hero Marine. Very comfortable looking, just as he was playing from home.
Well, he's not playing from home, and he's not playing on the European ladder anymore.
No, he's right now playing against the very top Protoss in the world. SKT1 recently finished second place in Pro League, so it really does not get any better than this. Didn't Classic also appear in an ace match, I believe, in the semifinals of the playoffs of Pro League? He was brought out over people like Sue and Bravo. So that just goes to show how much faith his team also has in him, and just how good his skill level
is. And most of all, Parting and Rain.
But I think they already played.
Yeah. It was in the alt kill format, okay.
Yeah.
Pretty good Protosses on that team, to say the least.
Yeah, really. Like, if you can work with guys like Rain and Parting every day, you don't really need much else. That's pretty much as good as it gets.
And he's finally gone for a quick scout here. Really wanting to see what he's up against. And it's funny, as I said, that one Rax, no gas expansion has kind of fell out of fashion. He goes for it. Man, if he goes for a third command center,
then you are pretty much the sickest caster ever. No doubt about that.
I hate you. Take it away.
All right, so far, nothing too much going on. Like you said and predicted, one Rex CC from Hero Marine. And Classic saw all of this. So Classic's Korean brain right now is going, what can I do against one Rex CC that puts me very far ahead? And something tells me that he has an answer.
We'll see in a second what this answer is, as he's still chrono boosting out probes. He's going to actually just go back home with the initial probe that he has sent out upon seeing there is no SCV at his natural, which actually is pretty close. He might cancel the Zealot. He did cancel the Zealot.
Yeah.
Still going to be able to throw that Nexus down.
A very fast Nexus here, so both players getting their expansions relatively fast. The Mothership Core even coming after the Nexus.
Yeah.
So that early scout allowing Classic to be extra greedy. And Hero Marine here adding a second Barracks.
Yeah, no very quick third command center here. And double gas behind this. So he's going to want to attack quickly.
Yeah, it looks like he might want to go for something similar as the last game. Maybe getting Stim and then rushing out two medivacs. Trying to put on some pressure. Maybe he thinks, because this map is a little bit shorter than the last one, he might be able to get something done. And classic so far.
I would have liked to see a third command center. Hero Marine
maybe
beat me many times on
for the last game.
Back in the old days on Whirlwind with three command centers. And every time I told myself I should have attacked before with some units, and the one time I did, he didn't go three command centers.
And you were really upset and probably raged.
Sad story. You know me well.
Yeah.
Classic is about to throw down something behind his mineral line. Is it gonna be a Stargate? Twilight. Five gates?
This map is rather notorious for being an awesome blink all in map.
Yeah.
So
is it now?
The fast Twilight. Well, I don't even play TVP, but I know that this is the best blink all in map there is, because all I see is people complaining about it.
Maybe you should unfollow Morrow on Twitter.
Yeah, I should have done that a long time ago, probably.
Stim packs on the way. Still no factory started by Hero Marine. He has the gas and the money. Delaying it a little bit here.
And the Mothership Core just peeking a little bit about what's going on. And he does actually end up seeing the two barracks and the Stim. So very efficient scout.
He's going quite far out of... Oh, he spots the factory.
This is actually a totally similar build to the last game for Hero Marine, except for the Reaper.
And you know what? I think if he throws down like four additional gateways now and goes for a big attack, Classic is probably going to be able to close out this series.
Is that how good Blink is?
Pretty much is. Actually, even better. In this case, Hero Marine going for the factory with only two barracks will be very vulnerable to any kind of attacks. Two gateways being thrown down. Three, maybe another one.
Yeah.
He hasn't taken the gases on his expansion, so...
This is the Blink all in. We're going to see it once again. And
why is it only four gateways in total?
Oh, it's also a forge.
Oh, yeah. So I guess, since he knows about the factory, he's going to want to get some cannons.
Oh,
and this gets scanned.
Money scan.
And he only sees... No, actually, no. Because he only sees the forge. He doesn't know how many gateways there are. I guess he can kind of anticipate.
So he sees the chrono boost on the blink, so he knows it's being chrono boosted.
Yeah. Then again, some producers, they start blink, but then they get a dark shrine and they still chrono boost this. Like, not seeing the number of gateways is a big deal here. Ideally, you want to know. Hero Marine still going to start a bunker, though, up his ramp. He's actually going to get medivac so quickly. Look at this.
Yeah, his medivacs are going to be really soon. And if Classic does not go very soon, then the medivacs will be done. He does get the armor upgrade. He's also getting the third and fourth gas on his natural. So Classic definitely not going fully all in with this, but still going to be quite a potent attack by him. And Hero Marine scouts it out, and his bunker will finish. So he should be able to survive here.
Truly.
I believe
so. I think you're quite familiar with Blink.
I've played a lot of TP games against Blink, against Classic especially, and I usually survive.
Okay, two medivacs are about to come out here. I think Classic is going to blink up in a second. He does. Actually, some SCVs are going to die before the fight even begins here. He's going to want to retreat up to that cliff over here to make sure he blinks down as only the shields are lost. One of the stalkers is going to fall. Two of them, actually. And he killed quite a few SCVs here. Nine in total.
Not too bad. I mean, he lost a lot of SCVs, but he's still alive. And Classic going to poke around to the natural, trying to get something done here. But there's already SCVs trying to repair the bunker. So Hero Marine doing a good job here. Of course, Hero Marine does not really know just exactly how all-in Classic is, which is one of the problems as a Terran player. Another four
more
stalkers being morphed in, so this is a lot of stalkers now.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if he starts charge and goes for Stormy, but Classic probably saw that he had a window of opportunity to do even more damage here. Oh, he has to be careful, Stim is used.
Stim and already three medivacs, so normally I feel it's going to be fine here. Classic needs to be careful, not lose too much, and he does back off.
Few more SCVs died, 12 in total have fallen this game. Two additional gateways being made, and Classic behind this with his upgrades. Well, at least with the upgrades. That he's getting the plus one ground armor. If he gets charged, he's going to be in great position. And there it is. He starts charge.
So have you been in this situation a lot where you do like kind of a blink attack, but aren't you scared because of the medevac count if you're not going to have Storm?
Yeah, but he... Oh, you mean for a counter-attack to be able to come back?
Yeah, like as soon as there's like five medevacs and Hero Marine decides to come back, because Hero Marine's not getting a third CC, just adding more barracks, so he's obviously going to go for huge two-base attack.
That's why he's getting as many gateways as he is. He's going to go up again to something like eight gateways, and in this case, seven to be more precise, and he's going to get a ton of Zealots from now, basically. Plus the charge, plus the ground armor, level 2.
Classic blinks into the natural while Hero Marine is far away out of position, and a lot more SCVs are going to die here. And this was a great move by Classic. He's not even going to lose a single stalker, probably.
That was great game sense here.
Not one stalker dies.
Not many people that actually try that, because this was very, very risky. Also, there is no recall on the ship core.
A little bit lucky, maybe.
No.
Yeah, he lost a pylon, so he knew that Hero Marine was far away.
Classic does not believe in luck, only his teammates do. That's why they touch his chin.
Yes. Do you think he touches his own chin before he plays? Someone will have to ask him about that whole story in the pre-game, after-game interview. Because it is actually a true story, and I think it's very interesting.
I'm not sure that's a good idea. I don't want Red Eye to get punched in the face. All right, Classic here is going to get engaged, and no, Hero Marine pulls back. He sees that he might not have enough. Actually, some nice stutter stepping here really will help, but there is charge plus blink, so actually Classic is on full chase mode right now. Yeah. Two Archons are on the way. Classic is going to go for a big timing here with Archons and a lot of Zealots with these Stalkers he has in support. He has Guardian Shield. He has quite a few Force Fields. And Hero Marine needs to wall off his natural here.
Hero Marine needs to realize what's going on, because there's charge, there's blink, there's Archons, and there's plus two armor. And Classic, it's really going to come down to how well he's going to be able to control these units. But this army is very, very, very scary.
He barely does not spot one of those pylons. He's going to realize now, but he's this too late. He has to pull all of the SCVs that he has on his natural. He's going to do just that. There's so much units, man.
But these Marines and Marauders are in a very good position, and all the mechs are healing very well. The Zealots now trying to get into the Marines. There's the Force Fields. And Blink's right on top of the ramp. This is so close. The Archons are doing so much damage. But for now, it looks like Hero Marine is just barely not able to hold on. So many SCVs died as well.
44 SCVs have been killed this game, and Classic is just going to close it out very quickly here. He doesn't have any time to waste. He wants his rematch versus MC. Enough is enough. Get out, Hero Marine.
Yeah, Classic made this one look so easy. He just kind of got a lot of units, Blink charged Archons, and jumped forward and just killed out Hero Marine straight up. Easy peasy.
Classic not joking around in this series.
No.
Not joking around. Oh, I saw some text I'm not going to like on this paper. I read through it.
The power of Protoss. Hero Marine with a big smile.
This is why he was smiling the whole time. He had planned for this to happen.
He was planning to lose just so he could pull out this paper and be a legend.
All right, Classic here.
Classic definitely a very powerful Protoss.
I thought for a second you were going to say a very powerful chin, which...
Well, that too.
...would have been highly inappropriate. But great games out
what
of him.
What did you think about his play as a fellow Protoss? Were you impressed?
Yeah, I was impressed. And you know what? Watching this build here, I actually... At some point, I kind of wondered what would happen if I did that myself on ladder. And then I pictured Stalkers dying, and I was like, why? Why is it so difficult to pull off something like this macro the way he did while putting on pressure? Because for me, I really feel like if you go into this kind of Stalker play, you really have to commit to it a little bit more. But Classic disagrees. He went for a few gateways. He made a bunch of Stalkers. He blinked up the ramp. He used some nice time warp, and he just traded shields a lot of the time, or a few Stalkers, for a lot of SCVs. And then behind this, he had done the damage he wanted. He did not commit anymore. He went for charge lots, ground armor, and his macro was impeccable. And as you said, razor-sharp builds.
Yeah. It seemed so straightforward. Like, he didn't bother with any of the fancy stuff, no robotics or storm, just straight up blink Stalkers into charge lot, kind of like manly style. I'm going to just kill you straight up, Protoss play, which was nice to see. And... You know, Hero Marine, unfortunately, his tournament is over, and there are officially no more foreigners in the tournament, other than the casters. So tomorrow, all right, so...
Congratulations, right?
Paul with the post-game interview. Take it away.
So, Hero Marine does unfortunately crash out of the tournament, does get a standing ovation from the crowd here in Germany. They will be seeing him in plenty more international tournaments to come. He's also given me the piece of paper, which I think you know what this says, Mr. Kim. So, ladies and gents, it is a very somber mood here in Germany now. But it's okay, because we've got more StarCraft coming after the break! Yeah!